welcome to Championship Wrestling at ringside. This is Vince McMahon along with wrestling's only living legend, Bruno Sammartino. Just moments away from a special tag team matchup involving Nikolai, Volkoff, and the Iron Sheik.
Vince, I've never seen them as quite as vicious as they are now. They are determined to keep those belts for a long time to come.
Also, to join us, you talk about the masters of the kung fu and karate and the martial arts in general, Ricky Steamboat.
Besides that, he is just a beautiful to watch, like an artist in that ring. Just sensational.
And also to join us, a most unusual athlete by any stretch of the imagination, George the Animal Steele.
Hey, unusual, right? But right now, I like George Steele. I like what's happening with him. I think it's people like him, too.
And also, in Piper's Pit will be Bobby the Brain Heenan, who will host Piper's Pit. Right now, let's go right up to ringside.
This contest is a tag team attraction scheduled for one fall. It is a non-title match. And introducing first to my left, the team comprised of, from Providence, Rhode Island, weighing 235 pounds, Sal Chi. His partner from Puerto Rico, weighing 231 pounds, Jose Luis Rivera. And now, may I introduce the manager, Classy Freddie Blassie. And he represents the current World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions. From Tehran, Iran, weighing 258 pounds, the Iron Sheik. And from the Soviet Union, at 313 pounds, Nikolai Volkoff.
Nikolai Volkoff and the Iron Sheik in a special non-title matchup here against Luis Rivera and Sal G. No doubt, Volkoff and the Sheik, Bruno Sammartino, are an awesome combination in almost every respect.
They certainly are. The Sheik, he displays, as we've said before, a lot of wrestling skills, many different versions of suplexes, whereas Volkoff also has tremendous wrestling skills, but he chooses just to be brutal in that ring. But the combination of these two is so awesome that I wish that somebody could come along and strip them of that title, but I think it's going to be quite a while before we will see that.
Then again, there are some great tag team combinations gunning for Nikolai Volkoff and the Iron Sheik, Freddie Blassie. So very, very proud of Nikolai Volkoff and the Iron Sheik. Last minute words of wisdom and advice. Locking up with Jose Luis Rivera, the Iron Sheik, in a standing headlock now. Rivera trying to set him up, whips it to the ropes now. Rivera himself hurling himself to the ropes. Round and round. Sheik goes down, Rivera over him, right back now. Sheik, oh, look at that one over. Right back to Luis Rivera, that's it. Rivera right on target. Now, off the rope, oh.
That's a mistake you can't make. You can't hesitate. And now look at this. Here's the Sheik on Rivera, ramming his head against that buckle, whipping him to center rope. Big back body. Wow, Rivera's in trouble.
Oh, wait a minute. Did you see what the Sheik did a moment ago?
I sure did, boy. I'll tell you, that's arrogance.
Freddie Blassie really enjoying what he's seeing, at least at the moment. Oh, head right into the booth of Nikolai Volkoff, the big Russian through the ropes now. Ooh. As you said earlier, Bruno, you see very little in the way of finesse and scientific wrestling skill on the part of Nikolai Volkoff.
And it's a shame that he is such a brutal, vicious man, because often people I know have asked me, this guy's so brutal, does he
wrestle? Ooh. Wait a minute, the fans, what are they looking at?
Oh, George Steele.
There's the animal. George the Animal Steele's trying to get in the ring. Lou Albano trying to pull him off. The Animal, George Steele, who obviously has no love for Volkoff or the Iron Sheik. The Animal is scheduled next. In the next match, he's not scheduled now.
I think, Vince, he was standing back here, was watching the matches, and I guess he just couldn't control himself.
Well, the match almost given to Volkoff and the Iron Sheik by way of disqualification moments ago, but it may be they're going for it now. Look at that, Sal G in the camel clutch, and the Iron Sheik wastes no time in defeating Sal G. Volkoff and the Iron Sheik victorious. Over the top rope, and down goes Luis Rivera. Sal G through the ropes as well. Let's go back, take a look at what we saw a little bit earlier on.
What we see here, here's a big suplex, typical of the Sheik with his suplexes. And with this, he follows this. Look at this, Sal G is down. He follows with the camel clutch, I believe, right here. Sets him up, drags him in the middle of the ring, sits on his back, and there he is applying this devastating camel clutch, which once applied, you just aren't gonna escape it.
That's for sure. Look at the Sheik rock way back. All kinds of pressure on the lower back, on the neck as well. The Iron Sheik eating up Sal G. And Sheik and Volkoff once again reign supreme as tag team champions. Let's take you to the update.
This week's update concerns a young man who is certainly making himself heard in the World Wrestling Federation circles. The Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart, not content with owning the contract of huge 450-pound King Kong Bundy, has also acquired the exclusive rights of Jim the Anvil Neidhart and the champion Greg the Hammer Valentine. Let us take a look at this dapper little manager as he goes into action.
What do you know?
A recent magazine quotes Jimmy Hart as saying, "The best shot is a cheap shot." Judging by the action of his wrestlers in and sometimes out of the ring, he appears to have established his message. One cannot deny his impressive success as a manager, but can it continue? Time alone will answer this question. This is Lord Alfred Hayes for Update.
Introducing first to my right, from Mesquite, Texas, weighing 281 pounds, Mike Powers. And his opponent, led down the aisle by his manager, Captain Louis Albano, from Detroit, Michigan, weighing 288 pounds, George the Animal Steele.
Where's the animal? There's no telling where the animal is. He certainly takes his time, and on an occasion, Bruno, he'll come in by way of a most unusual entrance.
That's for sure. You never know what George.
Oh, there he is. There he is. Look at him. This is vintage animal. Vintage. Has managed the animal through the years. I would suspect to say Albano has, well, he's more successfully managed the animal than any other individual. But it's tough for even a Lou Albano to keep this man under control.
It's tough for anybody to
get a t-shirt.
Yeah, look at that t-shirt.
It's tough to keep Lou Albano under control as well.
That's for sure.
Oh, look out. Here we go.
George the Animal Steele with Mike Powers, and Powers threw the ropes to the outside. The Animal goes right after him. The Animal does not care. Oh, wow! Look at that. The Animal take you any place you want to go and most places where you don't want to go. Look at that. Look at the fur. Well, it's actually hair. It's matted so thickly it almost appears as though it's fur over the shoulders and back of George the Animal Steele.
It looks like a grizzly bear, and he's just as tough as one. I thought it's big, awesome.
Yes, you'll see the tongue lapping about from time to time. The most unorthodox wrestler, bar none, I think.
For sure, he certainly is. But watch his agility from that almost 300 pounds.
Powers catches one in the lower abdomen area before he even got back into the ring. Referee warning George the Animal Steele of his tactics. That doesn't appear to be the presence of a patient man.
That's for sure.
Look at the tongue, Ooh. And right back down, George the Animal Steele with power just hammering away on him. I don't think. Look at that. Lou Albano with a few words.
I don't think his powers is too anxious to get back in the ring. Ever since the match started, Steele has really been on him. And then he threw him outside and caught him with a couple pretty hard blows. And, well, here he comes now. For a while, I thought he... Uh-oh. Here comes that hammer lock.
Oh, look at that. The Animal down on the bicep. On the oh, my goodness. A flying hammer lock. Chances are that'll be all she wrote for Mike Powers. Oh, my. The Animal does not mess around in there. And the Animal continues to stomp. And Lou Albano, again, trying to maintain some order, some control over George the Animal Steele. Look at Albano hitting George Steele.
Like a pet bear.
Yes. That is a most unusual combination. Lou Albano and the Animal.
Here is your winner, George the Animal Steele.
The Animal gets the Duke. When he's in the ring, he is a totally different person than you might suspect out of the ring. Look at that. That's an awesome sight just looking at it, much less attempting to wrestle with someone like that. Let's take you back down to the replay.
This is amazing. George Steele gets a hammer lock on Powers. But the amazing thing, Powers is a 280, 285-pound man. It's awfully heavy. And watch this. He scoops him up in the air. Of course, it's a submission. There's no way that they're lucky that their arm didn't break. And George Steele is the winner by submission. Watch the way he discards this Powers. Boom.
The Animal, with a victory under his belt, will take you now to a special interview.
All right, fans, stay tuned. More exciting World Wrestling Federation action coming up in just a moment or two. You know, we see a tremendous proliferation of top international stars arriving on the scene in the World Wrestling Federation. And I must prevail upon this gentleman to join me at this time. He is from the Hawaiian Islands. He is none other than Ricky Steamboat. Once again, welcome back. And Rick, you've had an opportunity now over a period of 2 or 3 months to assess the tremendously high level of competition. And, of course, talent available to the World Wrestling Federation. Your thoughts?
Well, Gene, my thoughts are this. When you have talent such as this coming into this area, because of the nationwide or the worldwide notoriety that an individual professional wrestler can get, obviously you're going to start to attract nothing but the top and the best in this field. And right now, as you see, I'm up here standing with a black karate gi, and what I'm doing, ladies and gentlemen, is because of competition is so tough, that I am starting to go back to what they say my roots and refer back to more of martial arts into the ring. Still keeping him within the rules of professional wrestling, but the fans will start to see more martial arts, maybe a different and a more, Ricky Steamboat to reckon with.
Well, I'll tell you what, you come from that part of the world. You obviously have a tremendous influence from the Oriental countries. Yes. And hence, of course, the martial arts. But certainly, it has got to come in handy here within the ranks of the World Wrestling Federation.
That's true, Gene, and I think with my martial art ability plus my wrestling ability, it'll be able to throw off a lot of the champions that are in this area. The Intercontinental Champion, Greg Valentine, maybe Jimmy Snuka and myself will get together, the SPC, for the World Tag Team Championship.
A good shot at it. I thank you very much. From Hawaii, Superstar Ricky Steamboat, and we're right back.
This contest is scheduled for one fall. About to enter the ring is the manager, Luscious John Valiant. And he represents, from parts unknown, weighing 293 pounds, the Spoiler. His opponent, from Tampa, Florida, weighing 277 pounds, Joe Mirto.
Pick Joe Mirto to meet one of the premier athletes for some time. The Spoiler, one of the most agile individuals, especially considering his size, I think you'll ever see in the ring. Mirto, top wrist lock, and right away backing himself, I think, to the corner is the Spoiler.
Two big men about the same size, weight-wise and so forth, but the Spoiler, he's made quite a name for himself through the years. He is one of the toughest men in that ring.
And the Spoiler, you will see, as he is now, making good use of the ropes. From time to time, as a matter of fact, we've seen him walking the top rope. Such is the agility possessed by the Spoiler. Mirto caught the toe of the boot there and appeared right on the side of the head.
And I think he's feeling good. Look at him. He's hurting.
Johnny Valiant certainly appreciating the talents of the Spoiler thus far.
Happy as a lark. Right now he knows that the Spoiler's got things under control. Mirto looks very hurt, and the referee should make him break from those ropes.
Referee having a somewhat of a difficult time attempting to maintain order with the Spoiler, as you might suspect he would. Mirto now with a Spoiler in the corner. Mirto, a big man, if he could get his weight behind some punches or whatever. I don't know.
Yeah, but you see, just had forearm blow he just delivered. That did not have a lot behind it. You have to put your weight behind it. Some guys just don't know how to do that.
The Spoiler now on the second rope. No, on the top rope. We'll see what the Spoiler's going to do with Mirto. Oh, my. Got across the back of the head. Awesome maneuver by the Spoiler. Drops the elbow. That could very well spell defeat right now for Joe Mirto.
See that elbow? He caught him right in the side of the head. I mean, really came down heavy. Now what?
Mirto thus far unable to use his size to his advantage. It's been all the Spoiler. Get a rope now right up against the throat area.
Ooh, wow. Now, when you take over and a man like Spoiler has, I doubt very, very much if Mirto will have anything to come back on. He may try, but all the steam is out of him now. Look at his boot right in the ribs.
The Spoiler making mincemeat of Joe Mirto at the moment. Yet to come here on Championship Wrestling. We certainly are looking forward to the matchup involving Ricky Steamboat. Also to join us, David Sammartino, and a most unusual individual by the name of the Missing Link. And Mirto continued to be hammered. Oh, my, from one side to the other. Uh-oh, now what? The Spoiler on the top rope. Mirto now gets up, tries to go for it. No, look at that maneuver. The Spoiler pulls him over, claps down a claw hold, covers his shoulders, and a three count.
I'm really surprised, but there was no contest with Spoiler from the very beginning, and he leveled it up and finally defeating Mirto.
Mirto certainly has given a much better accounting of himself in the past than what we saw here. I think the Spoiler still has the claw hold, however, on Joe Mirto. Where is the referee?
Well, he's been distracted by Johnny Valiant. Look at this.
Here's your winner, the Spoiler.
Spoiler, massive individual and extremely agile. Certainly knows his scientific wrestling as well. And the pride of one Luscious Johnny Valiant, as we take you now to the replay.
Look at this. He worked Mirto over throughout the whole bout. Now look at this. He's waiting for it. The sport is waiting like a cat. As Mirto gets up, look at this blow he delivers from the top rope. Boom, right on the side of the head. And Mirto was seeing stars as it was before that blow, so you can imagine where he's at now. And there's the pin.
All right, standing by, a special interview, after which we'll have here, the legend lives on, David Sammartino. Let's take you now to the interview.
All right, fans, we're going to get you back up into the ring for more exciting World Wrestling Federation action in just a moment or two. A lot of things happening in the World Wrestling Federation these days. One of the things I've just got to mention, the $25,000 bounty on the head of Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. That bounty being offered to Bobby the Brain Heenan, or by Bobby the Brain Heenan, to any wrestler who can put Paul Orndorff on the shelf and literally get Mr. Wonderful out of the hair of the weasel, of the brain, Bobby Heenan. Of course, the man who manages, I'm sorry, Big John Studd, Bobby Heenan managing The Missing Link, his latest edition. And you, sir, you still continue to persist in carrying out that bag of Andre the Giant's hair.
What's this reminder? That's right, it's Andre the Giant's hair. It reminds you what we are.
8 or 10 months ago.
Oh, that's right.
What have you done for us today? Forget about it.
What have we done for you today? We're going to get rid of Paul, Mr. Wonderful Orndorff. That's what we're going to do for you. We've got John Studd, the number one contender for the heavyweight championship belt, by getting rid of Andre the Giant. I'm the only giant left in wrestling today. I walk around with his hair. And do you know something, little man? When I step in the ring, you know what? Hey, let's get back to Ricky Steamboat. I understand he's going back to the old ways and his
going back
kung
to his
fu.
Roots, as he said.
The kung fu. What do you think would happen to Ricky Steamboat if he tried to use kung fu on me?
Well, no, the one thing about martial arts, I think that has been proven conclusively in a patent.
He would get hurt, just like Andrea got hurt when he tried to get tough with me. And now we've got Mr. Wonderful who's running around. You know, Bobby the Brain isn't here right now, but he's got a little message for you, Mr. Wonderful, and I'm going to deliver it.
Where is Bobby here?
He's working on something big, brother. He's working on something real big.
Movies? An NFL contract?
Something important, something to do with professional wrestling. Something that's going to make the wrestling world stand up on its toes again.
Weight unknown, the act. His opponent, from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, weighing 252 pounds, David Sammartino.
David Sammartino, preparing to lock up with the axe before this capacity crowd. David right away going for the standing side headlock. The axe tries to set him up, whips it to the far side now. Shoulder block. Ooh, nicely done by David. To the ropes again, over the axe now. David almost tripped up, right back at him, and the axe with a nice slam. Drop. Oh, this is the elbow. A lunge, and look at that arm drag. Another lunge, another arm drag by David Sammartino, and the axe takes a break. David coming on like a house of fire here, Bruno.
Well, he got caught with a pretty good body slam, and I guess he thought, hey, I better shake off this blow and come right back, and he did with two beautiful arm drags. But this axe, he looks pretty experienced. I don't know too much about him, but he's pretty quick himself.
All right, now David trying to set up the axe. David goes downstairs, the axe over, right back at him, over the hip, nice maneuver. The axe backing off again. David waiting for the axe. Now, getting ready to lock right back up. Standing side headlock now. David again shoved to the ropes and to the far side. The axe goes down. David over the back. And hope, no. David locks it up. And oh, look at that maneuver, would you? A cover. Almost a count of three. Nicely done by David Sammartino. Snap mare, over goes the axe. That was an unusual maneuver there.
Yeah, I was surprised because I thought he was going to get hip tossed. And, oh, this is this arm bar over here. Look at, well, a little while ago, he had the pressure. You could see that elbow really, well, right there. That is so painful. You know, most people watching don't see it, but that is extremely painful. Yeah, David caught him into the abdominal stretch, and then from there, he just threw him back, which, frankly, I've never seen that done before.
Almost in suplex fashion.
Arm, you're right.
David continues to work on the arm. Boy, I think he wants to take the arm and shoulder home with him here. You just don't want to mess around with David in there. He is all business. Ooh, wow, forget it. Ooh. Over goes the axe. And again, David continues to work on the arm.
Well, you know, you're weakening apart, whether it be the arm, the leg, and you're taking an awful lot from an opponent, because I guarantee you that this guy, the axe, his arm will not be the same, although...
Oh, it won't be the same after that with David hanging on.
Well, he hip-tossed David, but David hung on and just took the axe right over, hanging on to that arm bar.
Ooh, a regular face, I believe, on the part of the axe.
Yeah.
So now the axe resorting to the more aggressive type tactics. He has not had all that much success thus far with David with the scientific tactics. Sets him up, the axe does. David to the buckle, here comes the axe. Missing. David moving out of the way just in the nick of time. The axe a couple of beats off the pace there. David, what's he? Oh, how about that? Dropped him right across his knee.
Picked him up and dropped him on his knee. That's pretty hard because the guy's running. Boom.
Oh, my. A smack in the flesh resounding off the walls of the arena and again.
This is setting him up for the power slam, I'm sure.
Gets him up, yes. One, two, and lights out a tree. David Sammartino gets quite a roar from this capacity crowd as David proves his wrestling skills once again.
Here is your winner, David Sammartino.
David Sammartino, handsome young lad who's really climbing the ladder of success in the World Wrestling Federation. There are many who will stand in the way of the progress of one David Sammartino. There's no doubt of that.
There's a big power slam, and I'll tell you, when you apply that power slam and apply it properly, it is very difficult to get out, especially what David does, because when he power slams you, usually he scissors one leg, hooks the other leg, and he gets you in such a position that it's almost impossible to escape.
All right, standing by, Bobby the Brain Heenan, who this week will host Piper's Pit. Let's take you to Mr. Heenan.
Well, this is Bobby the Brain Heenan, as you all know, and I'm sitting in for my good friend Roddy Piper, who is on a much-deserved vacation. And my first guest right now is the, well, sit down, pal. Look like you could use the rest. Is the former Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, the former Tito Santana. Now, Tito, what I'm interested in is I put a $25,000 bounty on the carcass of Paul Orndorff. Since you're not the champion anymore, maybe you could use the change, huh? Were you interested in picking up 25,000 big ones? You could maybe send it home and get some pesos.
You know one thing, Bobby the Brain Heenan, the former manager of Paul Orndorff, I'm not interested in your $25,000, my man. You got them scums going after Paul Orndorff because you can't do the job. They're going after $25,000. Well, I'm gonna give you a warning and all those scums that are gonna collect, trying to collect. It's gonna be a cold day in hell for anybody that steps in the ring with Mr. Wonderful, brother.
Don't bet your life on it, Jack.
You know, that's the reason you're a former champion, is because you think like a person that's a loser. Now, pal, consider yourself lucky that I don't put a bounty on you. How would you like that, Mr. Santana?
Well, brother, if you got the money, go ahead and put it up, brother, because I got some for you, former manager of Paul Orndorff. I wouldn't mind teaming up with Paul Orndorff and going after your hide, brother. Maybe there'll be some bounties on your hide before it's all over, my man.
There'll be no bounties on my hide, because I'm Bobby the Brain Heenan, and I've got Stud, I've got Patera, I've got the missing link, I got... I'm talking, pal.
Bring it this time from San Benito, Texas, weighing 235 pounds, Aldo Marino. And his opponent, from parts unknown, weight unknown, Bobby the Brain Heenan presents the Missing Link.
Oh my goodness, what is that?
Yes,
the Missing Link, you can say that again. This capacity crowd wondering exactly what they are looking at. What? Look at this. Most peculiar.
What a face.
Aldo Marino
distracted just moments ago, and look at the leak. Series of headbutts to the sternum area. Missing with that shot, Aldo Marino back with a drop kick. And the link just pulled. Look at another headbutt by the link. Boom, my. Never seen anyone lunge with his head quite like this before. And again, look at that.
Headbutts, headbutts after headbutt. But I'll tell you though, look at his body. He looks like a really conditioned athlete, don't he?
There's no doubt about that.
He looks great.
I think he has busted himself open, the link has, I think, from a series of those hit again.
Oh, another one.
Bobby the Brain Heenan presenting the missing link. Look at this. What's he doing? Aldo goes downstairs.
Nothing.
Hammering away. Look at this. And the link with another headbutt. You see, the link, yes, has busted himself open there just above the eye. It doesn't stop him. Rams himself again, this time to the back of the head with Aldo Marino.
I don't think he knows what pain is. He is bleeding, and he must have delivered another half a dozen head blows. Look at that.
The link now with Aldo Marino. Oh, my, down to the canvas. Bobby the Brain Heenan really has a prize here. Look, he's giving himself headbutts, running the head. Of course, you see the cut above the left eye has had no effect whatsoever. Oh, my, on the missing link.
They're two like power slams. He's given two of them to Marino. Marino's hurt. Oh, look at this.
Oh, my, another headbutt. The link just using his head as a battering ram, and I think that could very well be it. Yes, indeed. Referee a little tentative in tapping the missing link on the shoulder, as you might suspect he would be. Bobby the Brain Heenan apparently having some difficulty. Bobby the Brain with the missing link, and I don't think the link knows exactly what to expect from these fans.
See what he does, he grabs himself in the back of the hair and he blunches forward like as if putting extra pressure in the back of his head to deliver a harder blow yet. Very unusual. I was gonna say, in all my career, I've never seen anything like this.
Bobby the Brain Heenan and the missing link. We'll get the official
here
word.
Is your winner, the missing link.
Every now and then, along will come someone like this whom they will really name appropriately. This is a prime example of that, the missing link, managed by Bobby the Brain Heenan. All right, let's go back if we have it now and take a look at some of the action we saw in the latter stages of the matchup.
Well, he gave him a couple, two of these, in fact, to me, they're just power slams, devastating. But from this, I believe this is where he goes up in the corner, leaps up like a, look at this, like a monkey, leaps up on those ropes. And now watch it. Boom, with his head, right on the side of the head of Marino. And boy, you know, that's it. Marino's going no place.
The missing link. The latest find of Bobby the Brain Heenan. We'll be back with Ricky Steamboat.
In the ring at this time, from parts unknown, weight unknown, Mr. X. And his opponent, from Hawaii, weighing 237 pounds, Ricky Steamboat.
Here comes the steamer over the top rope. All right. Woo, baby, watch out. And the steamer can get it done like no one else in professional wrestling.
This guy's dynamite. He is so quick. He knows so many moves. His wrestling is such a phenomenal wrestler. Then he knows all this karate, judo. He's just a complete athlete in that ring, I tell you.
Steamboat locking up with X. X knowing full well he's in there and gets one of the premier wrestlers in the World Wrestling Federation. X trying to set him up.
Whipped to the rope now. Steamboat coming up. Lowers the shoulder. Did he ever. Off again. Over X. Right back at him now. Going for the hip toss. No, nice reversal. Look how high Steamer took him. Up in the air. Oh, my. Ricky Steamboat all over Mr. X, who takes a powder. Steamboat. Well, the real head of steam here. And once he gets it up, you're not too likely to break him down.
Fine looking athlete. I'll tell you, this guy, he really, really has worked hard to be where he's at. He's a dedicated, dedicated man.
Articulate. Fine young gentleman. If you have the opportunity, you really could take the chance to meet Ricky Steamboat. He is a sensational gentleman. Top breast lock now. We'll see what. Let's look at this. That's one way to get behind someone. Oh, my. Look at that maneuver. And again. Look how high the Steamer gets up. Arm drag takedown. Unbelievable agility on the part of Steamboat.
Those leapfrogs. He shoots up there like he's jumping off a trampoline. And then the way he arm dragged him, he does it so beautifully, the way he uses his body for leverage and shoots his opponent clear over. Like he did with Sachi's. Just fantastic.
Excellent. The body slam now. Whoa, with a kick out by the Steamer. Arm drag, takedown again. X having his problems, as you might suspect.
Problems? Must be saying, what am I doing in here? How did I sign up for this match? This Steamboat's a ball of fire.
Has so much in his arsenal. X now trying to make a move on Ricky Steamboat. Whips him to the rope. Doesn't get down any lower. Steamer over X now. Right back at him. Oh, my. Look at that, would you? Oh, look at that. Wow. Oh, my goodness. What a maneuver on the part of Ricky Steamboat. Wow.
Mr. X was sure that he had thrown him over that top rope, but that Steamboat, he hooked that top rope, and beautifully the way he lifted himself up and curled himself back in. Mr. X tried to tackle him, and boy, there he went, shoot right out of that ring. Yeah, it's fantastic speed, I'll tell you.
Uh-oh, look at this. X now with Ricky Steamboat, has him by the ankle, and goes to work on him on the outside of the ring. Rams the head down into the apron. X now going downstairs. Uh-oh, no, aims it, runs him up. Ooh, by the shoulder, striking the ring post. And Ricky Steamboat, I believe, suffered some damage to his shoulder there after being rammed to the ring post. Break in the face. Mr. X hammering away on Ricky Steamboat, face first to the buckle. X all over him. And again, X going downstairs now. Winds him up, does X, rips him to the buckle, off to the rope, shoulder. Oh, nice maneuver, got the lower shoulder and shot him straight up in the air, back body drop. Ooh. Look at that one. Take down by, oh my. Steamboat now taking control.
Boy, is he ever. He caught him with a couple of karate blows there. And here comes,
Backbreaker. Ricky Steamboat asserting himself now, backs himself to the rope, there with a chop. Ricky Steamboat with a tremendous head of steam right now, and Mr. X to the rope. Ooh, my elbow downstairs. Oh, what a chop to the head. Steamer out on the apron. Up to the top rope. Mr. X lunging. Oh, my. One. We get two and three. Sensational victory for a sensational athlete, Ricky Steamboat.
The winner of this match, Ricky Steamboat.
Ricky Steamboat. I'm sure we'll be seeing a great deal of the Steamer in weeks to come. Boy, he is nothing short of sensational. All right, let's go back now to what we saw just moments ago. Ricky saying hello to so many of his fans there. And
look at this. Look at this from the top rope. Look how far this Mr. X is. I mean, he comes across way on the other side of the ring, catches him up high, and there he takes him down for the pin. That is such enormous agility. So unbelievable. He's got to be one of the most agile people, not only today, but ever in professional wrestling.
When we return, we'll have a word about Tito Santana, B. Brian Blair, and more on the Steamboat. Plus, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff, and a whole lot more. Stay with us. We'll be right back as we continue with more Championship Wrestling.
All right, you know, we've had an opportunity in the past to conduct at this time slot Managers Forum. Unfortunately, Jimmy Hart, I'm not going to be able to do that because I've only have you available, one manager, singular.
Well, let me tell you,
of course, you
what.
Are a manager of some pretty impressive individuals like King Kong Bundy.
King Kong Bundy, the big smash.
But I haven't seen him lately.
You know what? He's in Japan. You know why he's there? Because, you see, for some reason or other, Hulk Hogan won't put a championship matchup for us. So I sent King Kong Bundy to Japan, and when we get his name on the dotted line, Hulk Hogan's name, that is, then that's when Bundy comes back, and he'll be the next world champion, brother.
Okay. Well, what do you have here?
Thousands and thousands of cards and letters pouring each week. Everybody wants to know all about Greg the Hammer Valentine. Look
that's
at this right here. What about Greg? What about Greg?
Hey, as a matter of fact,
I brought him here right now.
Can I prevail upon our cameraman? I would like to have him get a shot.
I don't want anybody reading any mail that comes into us. Are you crazy? Can't come in here.
Okay.
This guy.
Intercontinental champion, Greg. He's got mail, too. Terrific.
Jimmy Hart, here's your check, man.
Oh, beautiful, baby.
What
thank
job
you so
well
much.
Done.
That's right. The man takes you care of me, Daddy.
You go right ahead and pay the man personally, don't you?
Hey, I figured I had it right there in my hand. I figured I might as well bring it right out here
right,
and give it to him. No big deal. And about all this fan mail, yes, this fan mail is for real. A lot of people
real.
Are really starting to realize
big
and appreciate.
Big mail sacks full of it. I see big mail sacks full of it for the two of you.
That's right. I thought you were trying to say something smart. Another smart joke from Mr. Mean Gene Okerlund. I understand you got some fan mail over there, too. In fact, I was reading something talking about how nice you look and how Jesse Ventura looks horrible and too punked out and should be nicely dressed
well,
like
I'll tell
himself.
Well, I'll tell you, it is fan mail. You'd have to fan it a little bit to get it to burn. It's really something else.
Why don't you talk about all the people that are trying to become Intercontinental
let's
Heavyweight
talk about,
Champion?
Let's talk again about Tito Santana. Let's talk about Junkyard Dog. And then
please.
Let's talk about newcomers all the time. Say the likes of a Ricky Steamboat, for instance.
Why do
that
you say that with so?
You
say that with so much enthusiasm. Are you trying to scare me or something with Ricky Steamboat?
Greg, come on, give me a break.
Nobody knows Steamboat better than I do. But one thing, Mean Gene, one thing does scare me is a man is going back to his roots and using his martial arts, whatever you call it, the karate. You understand that should be illegal
Kung
in professional
fu,
wrestling.
Judo. There's taekwondo, no, all
yes,
that stuff.
I don't know. You know all about it. You're a small man. You know all about it. Steamboat's a big man. He doesn't need that. You understand? He's a good wrestler. It should be illegal. And I know the man wants what I've got. Everybody wants what I got because I'm number one.
That's right,
and I'm going on further.
That's right,
because there's a world champion out there that's evading me all the time. Every time I send him a contract, he won't wrestle me belt against belt. I'm talking about Hulk Hogan.
Oh,
Hulk Hogan.
Very good.
I want him.
I thank you, Greg Valentine.
He doesn't want the hammer, but I want him.
Very good, gentlemen. I thank you very much. Intercontinental champ, Greg the Hammer Valentine.
Steamboat, next week here on Championship Wrestling. Also to join us, what a treat in store indeed for all of us when Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff, steps through the ropes.
I'll tell you, Orndorff's been a complete turnaround. The people love it, and I'll tell you, I get excited every time I see him in there. He's so fun to watch.
What intensity possessed by Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff. Also to join us, the tag team combination of Greg the Hammer Valentine and his partner Brutus Beefcake.
These two have teamed before, and I'll tell you, they are very, very successful together. They're quite a team.
Also to join us, as a matter of fact, all kinds of pro wrestling action, including the likes in Piper's Pit of Bobby the Brain Heenan, who once again